at the 1 Billion Rising Hong Kong Rights for Revolution. This is our fourth year of 1 Billion Rising. Every year I'm here for 1 Billion Rising, and I'm so excited to be here with Eve Ensler. You know, the issue of domestic and migrant workers is not just very close to my heart personally, but it's a very big issue that we are trying to platform with 1 Billion Rising. Just to give everyone a brief context, 1 Billion Rising is a global movement to end violence against women and girls, not just sexual, physical violence, but also economic violence. So we'll be hearing a lot about those issues today. And this year, as in past years, more than 200 countries have joined 1 Billion Rising. And our big day, of course, was Feb 14. And I know that some of you were already rising last Sunday. So Eve and I would like to thank all of you for moving your 1 Billion Rising event to today, Feb 21, so we could join you.
Of domestic workers and migrant workers is one of the most important things in the world to me. I stand in the deepest solidarity with you. I feel like how we treat workers, how we see workers, how we value workers, how we honor workers is critical to everything we do. And we know that women are the primary workers, and we don't get valued, we don't get honored, we don't get treated well. And your work needs to be valued. It needs to be seen, it needs to be cherished. So I'm here today to dance with you, to create revolution with you, and to say what happens to you matters, and it matters to everyone in the world. I love you all. Rise for revolution.
Greetings to everyone. We're very happy to join this time. Actually, we are employers, but we are also ordinary Hong Kong people. And we just want to express our solidarity. For us, the situation of working women, whether it's local or domestic worker, is important. And we think that violence against all women, all girls, should be valued. And right now in Hong Kong these days, there are a lot of people talking about no to violence. And there are signature campaigns. They're talking about violence in the street, but what employers, mothers, women, what we all see is violence in the home.
I'm here to represent International College Hong Kong, our school, and it's great to see so many people here to support this cause. And I would also like to take this opportunity to thank Ms. Ensler and Ms. Monique Wilson to be the pioneer for such a great cause. And earlier today, someone asked me why I was going that I'm fighting for, or why I'm rising. And my answer was that this really doesn't affect me directly. However, this is it is about solidarity, and it is about togetherness, and we must rise for our sisters, our mothers, daughters, everyone around us. And it's absolutely amazing to see so many of you here to support this event. And are you guys having fun so far?
Yes!
So thank you again for letting us be here, and I've had the privilege to join every single rising that has taken place in Hong Kong, and I wish to see this event grow even more and create awareness about some of the harsh injustice that the immigrant workers here suffer.
Everybody, yeah. I'm here to say the Rise Up for Revolution, the third time. So every time when I hear, I'm still is quite impressed that even the weather is cold, but the high spirit. As in, we are local women workers, and yeah, you do all industrial women workers in here. So many people just think Hong Kong is quite a safe place, but it's not the truth. The reality is that for local women, we are one of every seven women that have experienced the violence. What we identify the violence, not only abused by the, that number is they are abused by body, but not include those exploited by the system, and this discrimination by the system or many unequal, unjust issue, just exclude. But if we include that, that means women still in a quite vulnerable situation, even in Hong Kong, a global city. So we, as a local, and we have to solidarity to rise up for the social change. And in a society, we have to work together, because we know not only the government and also the society, they all know in here over 300,000 foreign domestic workers. They just know the number, but they not understand the situation, the actually to communicate or to learn more the story behind. So now we just say, as a woman and as a worker, we have to join hand in hand to against the violence, not only on the abuse, on the verbal, and also on the system. So this time you voice out for the system change, and you say you have to join together.
So the Asian Migrants Coordinating Body joins women and men all over the world calling for decisive actions to eliminate all forms of violence against women. There are 341,000 migrant domestic workers in Hong Kong, and these workers are facing different kinds of problems at work and back home. Asian women migrants experience violence in our living and working conditions. According to the Mission for Migrant Workers, one of the foremost charitable service institutions for migrants in distress in Hong Kong, their migrants clients for 2014 alone reached more than 4,000. This means that every day, 11 Asian women experience violence in various forms, including physical and sexual and economic, such as deprivation of rightful wage or exploitative practices of recruitment agencies. Violence against women migrants exists and persists because policies of the Hong Kong government set the stage for Asian women migrants to experience exclusion, exploitation, oppression, and abuse.